arm themselves, and the Oromo cannot sit back and watch in this, as this war goes on. Because for the TPLF, it's war by other means. It's not a political exercise. It's not a policy exercise. Number three, the Oromo person should always take the election as an act of resistance. In fact, as a war of resistance, because the election is a war by the TPLF. Therefore, it's a war of resistance. And the Oromo's election, taking part in election, is a war of resistance, and every Oromo should therefore take part in it with this in mind. And they should engage with it critically. Not because they will endorse the result at the end, but rather to engage with it critically and to bring to visibility the cries of the age, the problems that the Oromo has undergone. They also need to take the election practically, to use it critically, reflexively, without much hope in its potential delivery of good policy choices, but in its ability to slow down EPRDF violence and to take election in its disruptive capability. To the other peoples of the South, I think it's the same. Like the Oromo, they should not sit back and see. They should continue to resist by taking part in this election, because it is a moment of visibility for them. To the oppressed classes of the Abyssinian core and their figments and remnants in the imperial garrison towns of the South, meaning the oppressed Amhara community, for example, the poor, the uneducated, those who are marginalized from social services and economic facility, for all those people, this election is also a moment of resistance to the dominant hegemonic narrative of closure. Arrival at the Ethiopia, the Ethiopian government says that we have arrived, the nation is rebuilt by the nations, the nationalities and peoples. Now we have development, paradise is attained, and there is no need to complain. We have only a policy choice, etc. That's the kind of narrative the state wants to give. And the Amhara poor class, therefore, also resist that story, and they complicate and disrupt the TPLF story of hegemony to bring in their own story of suffering, their own story of pain, hunger, and ignorance and neglect under oppressive regimes for ages and ages, irrespective of the fact that the ruling classes always talked about ruling the empire in the name of the Amhara. Now, the Amhara, however, should also demand now a complete break from the past. They should not tinker with this idea, the first with this idea of reforming and repairing the old imperial state. And they should really break away from the nostalgia for empire. And they should really want a new beginning, in a sense, a revolution period. So when they take part in this election, it is with that in mind that they should approach it. So for everyone in Ethiopia today, the election is simply a participation in war. It is not participation in resistance, which is not a participation in civil politics, in politics of policy choices, in politics of leadership choices. And that's my take, Ali.
Thank you very much, Agaye. We really appreciate for your input.
All right.